Welcome together to our webinar. My name is Carsten. I will show you and explain you today what are the options in BEAS to managing disassembly items. It's meaning negative BOMs. Which terms do we associate with negative bill of materials in BEAS? We can have co-products, byproducts, and dismantling. Co-products are usable products which are automatically generated during the production of the main product. Byproducts are traditionally referred to as anything that occurs incidentally and often undesirably during the manufacture of a main product. Dismantling is a disassembly of assemblies and the return of components from the assembly to stock, to the warehouse. Here I have any basic information for negative BOMs in BEAS. Principally, you enter the quantity in the BOM position as a negative entry. Negative BOMs, BOM items are evaluated as planned receipts in the order recommendation. In the backflush posting transaction, negative items are posted automatically or manually, for example, when we have items which are batch related or serial numbers related. Negative BOMs BOM items can be reserved for sale orders or planned issues. When work orders are merged, the individual receipts are inserted as negative BOMs BOM items and posted correctly to the VIA account. Here I have a simple example how we create in BEAS the BOM. When we merge the production orders, the work orders, then we have to do a little configuration in the configuration wizard. Now I will show you in the system the configuration and the structure and the operations, the processes, what we can do. Let us start with the configuration for our merged work orders. Here under production, under create, we have to set a phantom assembly. For our master data, I show you two examples what we can do. I have here a finished product, and in my case, I say when I make the final assembly, I will change my motherboard. That means I bring an existing motherboard on stock and I use another motherboard for my finished product. When I open the BOM position, we can see here our negative entry for this item, what we want to give on the stock later. Then here I have an example for a byproduct. For example, here when I finish my finished product 2, my byproduct screw comes on stock with 4 pieces. Then I prepared sales orders. And in BEAS, we have a function named sales order to production order. From here, I can create my work orders. And I have different options here. For example, you see here, I have different products. And for example, I can now bring different products in one work order. So that means I merge different sales orders to one work order. For this, I click here on merge. Then the system will open a little window and will show me some restrictions. I click OK. And in the background, the system create now a work order with all positions what I selected here. When I open now the work order, I will see here my item from the configuration wizard, my Phantom assembly. And when I open this, then I find here my 2 positions from the sales order. I can open here the structure and see my sales order. Can open from here also the sales order with left mouse double click. And the system will show me the cross reference. And from here, I can directly go into sub sales order. In my structure, I found also my bill of material positions. And here you see our positions with the negative entry. I see this in a other color and with the other button here. And when I open, you will see here the entry in minus. When I have, for example, 3 items with the same material with minus entries, the system will write here one position with the summary of all entries. So let's make from here a material issue. And in my example, I have it make a little bit difficult, excuse me. So normally I say here all pre-assign and then I book. And you see 2 lines are not designed here. So that means I have here a position with a serial number. And here I have a material with batch number. So, and I have to give the quantity here in this field. And you will see the system make the reservation and now I can book all materials. And I will show you now the results. Here you see a new line with journal entries, and when you open the positions, you find also here the journal entries for the booking. And I can also open here directly the journal entry in SAP. So we see by our material MAT03, we have now received over 4 inches. And here by our motherboard, we have also received over 1 piece. And our normal bomb position has the issue with the correct quantity. Okay, let us make a new sales order and see how is MRP working with this negative bombs. I have here a normal standard scenario and I calculate new. The system is running. And you remember we had 2 motherboards in our BOM. So I can, for example, here by a description make a filter and say I will see only the motherboards. And here in this window, you see if is a inflow or a outflow quantity. So for example, here we need this motherboard for our final product. So for this, we have yet now here an outflow quantity, and this motherboard comes from the work order on stock. So we see we have here the inflow, and the same information you find in the inventory history. Here you can see also the same information. Okay, this was all information to the negative bombs from my side. Are there any questions?